Chris Menard here. I've got a fantastic video. We're going to do grouping inside of a pivot table, but we're also going to use ChatGPT-5 inside of the free version of Copilot to help us figure out what to group by. Let's dive in right now. In my Excel file, I have a list of car brands over here in column B. And just to make this official, if I was going to really do this, I would use the unique function, make sure how many car brands I have. And there we go. I don't see Toyota twice. I don't see Ford twice. That would be because someone is doing extra spaces with the space bar. So let me get rid of that. That was a unique function, not required. Just wanted to show it to you. You would also see this inside the pivot table. So I'm going to go ahead and make my pivot table, insert pivot table, hit OK. I need to see the car brands, and I want to summarize the invoice amount. There's my data. So what I want to know is, for these car brands, what country are they from? As an example, we've got USA, we've got Toyota and Nissan or Japan, but I want to make sure I get these correct. So I'm going to highlight these car brands. Copy them. I'm over in Microsoft Copilot, the free one. It says web because I have a subscription. If it doesn't say web and you have an enterprise business account, this will still work. Here is try ChatGPT-5. It is now running. In my prompt box, I told it to let me know what countries these car brands are in, and I pasted that data. It's going to come back and hopefully let me know that information is correct. I told Copilot to put this in a table and sort by country. So I asked it to sort by country, and there is the result sitting there in a table. That is exactly what I want. So now I'm going to go ahead and do the country of Japan first with these five different brands. Then I'll do USA, Italy, and Germany. It doesn't matter what order you do these in. I'm back in Microsoft Excel. I'm going to select Acura. I'm holding down the control key. Let's pick up Honda, Mazda, Nissan, Toyota. Right click on any one of those, and I have an option to group. It went ahead and grouped all of them. This sometimes throws people off, but it does say group one up here. Click on group one. I named group one Japan. BMW was Germany. Fiat was Italy. Now, Ford, GM, and GMC are USA, so I'm going to select Ford. Notice I picked Ford, the actual value in A15. I got GM and I got GMC again using the control key. Select, right click, group. It named it group two. I'm going to call this USA. And there is grouping with a pivot table. And I frequently need that actually in my job, but I definitely need it here with this video I'm making. Great feature. In case you're wondering, Chris, could you have used a VLOOKUP or an XLOOKUP in your data? Yes, I could have, though I would have had to create another data set with all the car brands and their countries. I would have had to insert a column and done a VLOOKUP or an XLOOKUP. That would have definitely worked. But sometimes I find it easier with just a small amount of data just to go ahead and do the grouping inside the pivot table. And one other item, you can sit here and manually collapse and manually expand. And you can right click and you can collapse them all and expand them all with your right click menu right here. Thank you for your time. Have a wonderful day. My online training is available for Copilot, Excel, Teams, and OneNote. Thank you.